glad of knowing how to trust God. Just stand. We're not going to point you out any further. We're just going to pray. And I'm going to pray for everyone here. Everyone. But would you please look at those around you? Would you please pray with them right now? Lord Jesus, last few weeks you've been telling us over and over in your word that whether we're facing a fiery furnace or as today we move toward a lion's den, that you will not leave us, that you will not forsake us, that there is nothing, nothing, nothing too difficult for you, that you're able to look exceedingly abundantly above even all that we asked this morning or could even imagine. Lord, you promised us that you would not hide your face from us. And Lord, as these folks have stood, they didn't stand and inform you. You knew already every one of their heartaches, their struggles, and their fears, their hurts, their diagnosis. You knew every one. And Lord, my word that I've read says that you cared. Every time we heard a word that was frightening, your heart was touched. Thank you, Lord, that as we come this morning, we don't have to twist the arm of a powerful but non-caring God. All we have to do is pray in the name that is above every name, the name where we can run to and be safe. And we ask today in Jesus' name that sickness would be healed across this congregation this morning and in the lives of those that we represent. I pray against cancer in the name of Jesus. And I pray that cancer cells die because of the touch of the great physician in the lives of those that we love and care for this morning. I pray, O Lord, for a quickening of the heart muscle where there's weakness and there's been a problem. I pray, O Lord, for a quickening of the spirit for those who are this morning discouraged and sad. Pray that in your presence is where they will find joy and strength and power. Lord, we proclaim out loud that we trust you with our life. And we hear your word saying to us that you will fight our battles, that you will go before us, that we will be more than conquerors through Christ who strengthens. Lord Jesus, today, I pray for physical strength, spiritual growth, for divine healing, for deliverance, for restoration, for your love to be manifest today over this congregation and over those who we represent. For you are the resurrection and the life, and all power is in your hands. And we lean on the everlasting arms of our Lord. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. When we stand here in the pulpit, we know partially what's going on in the lives of those here. We understand even less than we know. But please know that the one who called you, the apple of his eye, not only aware but moved by your situation. And he's able and desires to change your situation. Not just alter it, transform it by his power and in his name. Walk in that faith today and believe the Holy Spirit has spoken to us. We could go, but we've had enough of the sermon. But don't. I want to talk to you a little bit before we quit. But right now, what I want you to do is stand. We've got folks in this room that you've never met before. Would you do that right now? Find somebody you've not met before and just say hello and greet them. And as you go by, you can actually give a high five to somebody you know. But we even love to.